Take your seats, please.
Why else would he be there?
Same reason, same time.
Okay, can you take your seats, please, folks? Take your seats.
Don't mind doing that next time, that's for me to help
you. Councillor Gray, you're going to know something. No, I'm not having any more debates. I'm not saying any more debates. Councillor Lesley, you have an opportunity to speak.
I'm talking to the judge.
Thank you. Can you speak a little quieter then, please? So you're not impacting on the meeting. Chair. Councillor Lewis, you wanted to say something.
Can I just
me,
I think I'm no one's going to be asked, so can I just interject, Chair, and say this comment made from the audience. So during the adjournments, the move of the motion requested by advice on the phraseology of a motion that would amount to a sound decision. I gave that advice. That's the same advice as I give any member here who asks for that advice, either during a meeting or this evening.
Can I thank you for that? And anyone who wouldn't accept that in the manner in which it's given really needs the bumps feeling. Councillor Mitchell.
Thank you, Chair. During the recess, I myself thought my colleagues might come up with some way to do that. So I've had a motion.
Okay, Councillor Perry.
Thank you, Chair. I'd just like an answer, please, from Director of Government and Insurance. We had a call in for Section 75. For the same committee which I sat on, for the joint funding of the CCG, which was allowed to be referred back to full council. What's the difference between that decision and this decision?
Chair, I wasn't present at that meeting, but I understand some advice was given. I don't think that, if I'm frank, I don't think that advice was given as strongly as it could have been. Was referred to full council and delaying the ability of the council to implement that decision without undue harm to the council and its ability to administer the functions it has.
Thank you. Councillor Mitchell.
Thank you, Chair. If I may.
Quiet, please, folks. Can we just listen to the council when he's talking? Thank you.
It's in three parts. First one, cabinet member to set out a timetable and programme for the publication of all studies. Two, to set out costs of consultants proposed to be employed and identify all budget headings. Three, report to cabinet on a structure for members-led consultation after discussion with all parties to ensure details of all studies are available. Thank you.
Okay, you're formally moving that.
I have.
Do we have a second then? Councillor Lewis, all those in favour? Sorry, this is a new amendment. Sorry, to go back to the original amendment. Councillor Gray.
Forgive me, Chair. Sorry, I've just moved straight to the vote and I'm just asking the question, was there an amendment? Not to confuse
Councillor Mitchell, you proposed. Councillor Lewis, you you second it? All those in favour, please show.
Sorry, Mayor. Chair, I'm confused, so I guess some other people maybe as well. Forgive me if it is only me. So, Councillor Mitchell, was that a motion standing on its own? Was that an amendment? It's what Councillor Gray was trying to say.
Was a motion standing on its own.
A motion standing on its own. Thank you.
Sure. So, I have a second.
Okay, just a minute, Councillor Muspratt, please. It was proposed, it was seconded. Can I ask you again? All those in favour, please show.
You heard what I said.
Sorry, Chair, we're going to ask the question because it might be Councillor Muspratt is trying to move an amendment to that. So we skipped a little process there to say that was an original motion. Is there there just needs to be a short pause to allow any member to move an amendment if they wish.
Yes, we have an amendment to Councillor Sykes' original.
Now, my understanding of that original motion was withdrawn. Is that correct, Councillor Sykes? It's fallen. Okay, it's fallen.
There's nothing to amend.
Okay. Can we go back to the motion that's just been put, please? We were halfway through a vote on that. We half voted. I didn't get an opportunity to finish what I was saying.
Chair, so I have a point of information. If this motion goes through, can we move another motion?
No.
Because at the moment, we've got two motions and we haven't heard one.
Can we go back up to
you? Should they have a motion?
That's my question, Chair, which is, the situation as it stands is that a motion has been put forward and seconded, so that will be voted upon. If that's carried, then that is the outcome of this evening's meeting. Thus the question, because actually it doesn't necessarily conflict with everything that Councillor Gray said, and thus the question that I was posing for the Chair to ask was, is there an amendment to Councillor Mitchell's motion or not?
Okay, well that seems pretty straightforward. Is there an amendment to Councillor Mitchell's?
Yes.
Okay.
So we wanted to have a simplified version. So having sort of legal advice on phraseology, my original meaning before was that I wanted to refer the decision back to Cabinet, for Cabinet to reconsider its decision to ensure information on any decision is fully published and that there is as full of involvement as is practical of a cross-party working group.
So that there will be an addition of words to Councillor Mitchell's motion. Is that so?
Do we have a second of the Councillor Gray's amendment? Councillor Jones. Right, we vote on that amendment first then. Can you just read out the amendment again, please, Councillor?
We wanted to refer back to Cabinet, for Cabinet to reconsider its decision to ensure information on any decision is fully published and that there is as full as an involvement as is practical of a cross-party working group.
Okay, and that has a seconder. Councillor Jones, you seconded that. All those in favour of that, please show. All those against. So that falls. Any abstentions? Thank you. Councillor Bird.
So the amendment to the motion is that, to add that the Cabinet member takes further action towards a cross-party working group on the local plan and provides continued further information to answer questions from all backbench elected members.
I'm sorry you confused me. If you say that again, particularly if it's an amendment, it's an amendment to what?
To
Councillor Mitchell.
To add
this further way to a charge.
In addition. The Cabinet member should take further action towards a cross-party working group on the local plan and provide continual further information to answer questions from all backbench elected members.
Okay, there's someone second now. Seconded by Kate.
Sorry, Chair, the point of order. Does that amendment mean that all the wording from Councillor Mitchell still stands?
Yes.
And this
yes.
is just added at the end. Yes. In which case, can somebody read out the whole amendment, please?
Can we have Councillor Mitchell
again? That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, don't say my Councillor Mitchell.
One, Cabinet members to set out a timetable and a programme of publication of all studies. Two, set out costs for consultants proposed to be employed and identify all budget headings. Three, report to Cabinet on a structure for member-led consultation. After discussions with all parties to ensure details of all studies are available.
In addition, to take further action towards cross-party working group on the local plan, and provide continual further information in answer to questions from backbench elected members.
Double endeavours,
yeah. Okay, so,
Ross,
amendment first. We're going to vote on the amendment first. Thank you very much. And I thank the attendance. I thank the members of the public and the officers who attended as well. Thank you.